What is up, YouTube? My name is Silver, and welcome back to my channel. I really hope this sounds good. If there's a little bit of static, that might be from my fan that's currently blowing, because it's like 80 degrees outside, and my fan blows cold air from 80 degree weather, so I'm sorry. I did do some test streams before recording this, so I might be streaming today, later today. Keep an eye out. Yeah. If you guys don't know what I was doing, I was just dabbing. I'm kind of ashamed of myself for dabbing. So guys, as you can see in the top of my screen, as the always and most beautiful selection, we are doing more Cardfight Vanguard release info of Dragon's King Awakening. I personally like the other name it had. I can't remember what it is now, but I liked it. So we're going to start off with the most essential support. Just ignore that card. We're going to start off with the Chronojet support, because that's what this world needed, was more Chronojet. And its name is Chrono Dragon Gear Next. Top banter. Like I said, Gear Chronicle was suffering. It was really, really dying out. I thought my favorite clan of Time Dragons was going to die, lose its momentum. But I'm really, really, really glad they gave it more support, because we needed another $40+ grade 4 that no one else can afford. So, top banter. I went through the comic sections. I gotta pull it up. But I found a comment that I thought would be perfect, just absolutely riveting for a skill. So I'm going to read it to you, and you guys tell me if you like it. It's a continuous Vanguard GB3. While you have a Chronojet heart, this unit gains the effects from all face-up Gear Dragons and Zodiac Time Beasts in both players' G-Zone. So if you're facing another gear deck, perfect. You're now getting ridiculous broken skills. If that wasn't bad enough, it also has an auto Vanguard. When you would pay the cost to activate a Vanguard's effect, you may choose one of your Vanguards and deal 1 damage to it instead. If you do, the cost is nullified. Perfect. I love being at 1 damage and just dealing myself 4 damage for broken skills like GB8. Oh, wow. Beyond Orb. It would... Ah, beautiful. And it gets better, because, you know, Gear Chronicle again needed the support. This unit does not return to your G-Zone during your end phase. You cannot stride, ride, or place any cards on the Vanguard while this card is face up on your Vanguard. Because we really, really needed a Permo G4 on the Vanguard to make the deck even more broken. During your opponent's turn, though, your heart's power does become zero, so that's a bonus. You may choose one face-down card from your G-Zone and turn it face-up, and it's an axe skill once per turn. So, just like I said, I really hope Bushiroad does not make that card. I really hope this card is underappreciated, is like a single rare, maybe double rare, something affordable. Maybe it's just like another next stage. I don't know, guys. This card is just bad, and I don't think it should be allowed to exist. But that's my personal opinion. Gear Chronicle definitely didn't need the support, just in case no one caught sarcasm in that at all. But you never know with people these days. So we're going to move on to the actual card I'm really excited for, and have a skill to read off as well for it. So we have our little Luard card here, which is Awakening Dragon Luard. So as Black Moon said, this looks to be Luard's final evolutionary stride, whereas he's slowly become more and more of a dragon each and every time, and now he's just completed it. And I actually like the skill I found, so I'm going to read this one, and I really hope this is his actual skill. GB Break, Generation Break 2, Ritual 7. Ritual 7, activate this effect when there are 3 more cards in your drop zone. Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1, choose a card face down from your G-Zone, turn it face up. Choose the same number of rearguards equal to the number of cards face up in your G-Zone, retire them. At the end of battle, if this unit attacked a Vanguard, you may pay the cost. If you do, stand this, and it gains 3k for each grade 1 in your drop zone. If 3 more rearguards were retired, This unit gains 5 to gain a crit, and if 5 or more units are retired, your opponent cannot call cards from hand to guard until end of battle. Your opponent's rear guards get retired with this effect. So yeah, and the guy that came up with it also stated that your opponent's rear guards get to be retired with it as well. Which makes this card really nice, because from this skill, it doesn't lose its triple drive, so it's going to be 6 damage. I think maybe there will have to be some sort of discard in there for it to work. Like maybe Counterblast 1, Soul Blast 1. Flip a G unit face up and discard a card at the end of battle, you may pay the cost, would be, I mean, that would probably be also one of the most resource absorbing skills out there, which would make it balanced, because you retire, you choose up to 10 rear guards, you retire all 10, and you get 3k for every rear guard in your drop zone, or every grade 1, whereas the Luard decks thrive off grade 1s. Like, I've seen some decks only run 4 grade 2s, and they are terrifying. So I'm actually really excited for the Luard card. I'm really glad that he's getting support, because I love Luard. Just in case you guys didn't know, I got the Luard trial deck for Christmas. Me and my brother both did. And I was really happy because I pulled out the, foil card. The hot stamped one. That's what it's called. Sorry, it's like almost 2 o'clock in the morning here. So I pulled out the hot stamp, and for 2 years now, every Christmas I just end up getting a hot stamp card. So it's like every Christmas that comes around, I ask for a trial deck, I get it, I get the hot stamp. It makes me really excited. For the rest of the year, I have bad luck. So it just tends to happen out like that. I really enjoy it, but it could always be worse. So we'll move on to the next card I'm excited for, which is Evil Eye Emperor Shiri Murakumo, which is kind of unique in a way. I mean, this is all sleeve art as well, so this might not be the official names, but I like the, one, I like the art. Two, I like how Nubatama's new skills line up. I really love Domination, and I can't wait until the deck comes out so I can get it and play around with it. But the skill, I also have a skill here for it that someone came up with online, and I like it. It's a Domination Act, Counterblast 2, discard 2 cards from hand at the beginning of your battle phase. If you dominate 2 or more units before the battle phase, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose up to the same cards from your opponent's hand, as well as face-up cards with G units with dominate in your G zone, and call them to different rearguard circles. The dominated player chooses the locations. They get 8k and dominate them. If 3 or more were called, this unit gets auto plus 10k a crit, and your opponent cannot call grid 1s or higher to the guard circle. Auto GB3. At the end of battle that this unit attacked, if you dominate 4 or more units this turn, this gets auto once per turn, Counterblast 2 or Soul Blast 2. You may stride this card, and it gets minus 2 drive. So what it's doing is recycling the stride, but you lose out on its early act skill. It also has an auto. When this unit is placed on van, choose 2 of your opponent's rear guards on the field, give them AK, and dominate. So this is a really nice dominating skill. So it starts off at a GB2. So right off the bat, it's GB2. You could use this as a first stride, and next turn follow it up, start spamming its skill, and it just is nice because it's like, oh, I'm going to Soul Blast 2, stride skill, dominate 2, attack, Soul Blast 2, stride, dominate, attack, and you're going to constantly get 3 attacks in a row, which would make this card really nice, but I also see it making it very expensive. So I hope Bushiro doesn't go down this path. I want to be able to build dominate decks while they're still popular, but I can't if the cards become too expensive. Like I said, I plan on getting a handful of trial decks to open them and see if I can pull a hot stamp. But that's all the skills I found. I really haven't looked. I got these a couple days ago, so from the wiki that I use, so it was really nice. But we'll just move on into a couple of the other card art released. So we got Goddess of Still Water. So this looks to be a goddess unit for Oracle Think Tank, which isn't bad. I'm really excited to see what her skill might be. Got some blurry art there. I'm going to close these out just so I'm not lagging my computer. We'll move on to the next one. We have Conquering Supreme Dragon, Dragonic Vanquisher V Buster. And it's probably going to be a really powerful unit. A lot of people are hoping it has first turn stride, or the first stride skill, so it's not broken, but it's not good either. Maybe it's like a buster. Oh, well, it is V Buster, so haha! We're going to see another buster unit. Yeah! I hope not. So yeah, that's him. Nothing really. Maybe if we scroll through the comments here. If you guys want to pause the video now and read this, go right ahead. I'm not. I'm really tired, so I'm just going to continue. Moving on, we have Midsummer Flower Princess Retalia. So me and Black Moon were both wrong. This is not a Mustic tier. This is probably more Asha support because it has a season and it's a Flower Princess. Hooray! My dreams are coming true. So I was really hoping this would be Mustic tier support for the whole Miguel, but I don't think we're going to get any form of Miguel bonus in the future, so that makes me sad. If you don't know who Miguel is, please go watch the anime. It's really good. We'll move on. Now we're going to actually move on to the four cards with actual skills and sort of go over them because they're important-ish. So we'll start off with this. This looks to be a Oracle Think Tank unit. It's a ghost. And its skill is GB1. Retire this unit. When attack hits, you may pay the cost. If you do, draw two cards. And if the number of cards in your hand is six or more, countercharge and soul charge one. So it's a nice resource rebuilder. I see people running this at least one or two in their deck for a nice resource replenish. Past that, it's an okay card. It's a common. That's all we got this week. So we got to learn to deal. Moving on to by far my favorite artwork thus far I've seen. Drifterworld, I can't say that. It's a Shadow Paladin High Beast 5k starter. And it's Generation Break 1, Ritual 3. Put this card into your soul when this unit is retired for an effect of a cost. For a cost card with ritual ability, you may pay the cost. If you do, look at the top card of your deck, call it to rear, or put it into your drop zone. So this will allow you to get ritual off if you don't have it. Actually, no, it has to be four ritual skills. So it's going to add to your ritual later on, which is really good. But overall, yeah, like, I mean, look at this art. Like, who could not love that art? Look at thumbnail material right there. We're just going to drag. Nope, come on. Damn. Darn. Okay, well, I'll play around with that later. We're not going to get rid of him. Next, we have the Air Element Berling. It's from this set, obviously. It has, when your opponent's deck is shuffled due to an effect from one of your opponent's cards, until end of turn, this unit gets 5k in resist. 5k power and continuous resistance, which I guess is okay. I would prefer to have 5k in its defense, making people more weary of shuffling. But I guess that would make it broken. Yeah. I really wish it got 5k shield instead of 5k power. Because if your opponent's deck is just shuffled, unless you're playing against decks that call a lot from deck 2 guard and then shuffle, this isn't going to do you a whole lot of good in the attack field. Personal opinion, obviously. We'll move on to the final card we have, which is Shutdown Annihilator. So it looks like Annihilators are getting support. This is, when this unit attacks, if you have a Vanguard with Annihilator's name, it gets plus 2k. To end of battle, counterblast 1. At the end of battle, let your grade 3 or greater Vanguard attack with Annihilator's card name. If the attack did not hit, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your Vanguards and it gets 5k until end of turn. So it's an okay card. I'm not a big fan of it, but hey. So that being said, my favorite card thus far that I plan on getting is this unit. But I will see you all later. I'm very tired. I'm off to bed. I'm the Silver Wolf. Peace. Look out for the live stream later.